the Church of St. Thomas the Apostle as we celebrate the 16th Sunday of Ordinary Time.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. There is no God besides you who have the care of all, that you need to show that you have not unjustly condemned. For your might is the source of justice. Your mastery over things makes you lenient to all. For you show your might when the perfection of your power is disbelieved, and in those who know you, you rebuke temerity. But though you are master of might, you judge with clemency, and with much lenience you govern us. Power, whenever you will, attends you. And you taught your people by these deeds that those who are just must be kind, and you gave your children good ground for hope that you would permit repentance for their sins. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Abounding in kindness to all who call on
comes to the aid of our weakness, for we do not know how to pray as we ought, but the Spirit himself intercedes with inexpressible groanings. And the one who searches hearts knows what is the intention of the Spirit, because he intercedes for the holy ones according to God's will. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. But God knows the difference between the two. and will sort them out in his time. So, praying about this, two things occurred to me that I think Jesus is speaking to me and perhaps to you through this parable. One is to not be so quick to try to figure out who amongst us are the wheat and the weeds. Not be too quick to judge, but to trust God. We should pray, but we should trust God to care for those, to turn the hearts of those who perhaps are weeds so that they can join together with the wheat. But secondly, I think Jesus is telling us to tend the gardens of our own lives, to be careful what seeds we plant in the soil of our faith. See, we know when the seeds planted in our soil are the seeds planted by Jesus, when they produce fruit. Fruit in our lives that manifests itself in love for our brother and sister, compassion, mercy, generosity, charity. But the world can be kind of a hectic, fast-moving place, especially today when the news piles itself on top of each other and we think, my goodness, can we put 2020 in the rearview mirror eventually? But in the middle of that, sometimes we might not be too sure what seed we're planting in our soil. Is it producing greed? Is it producing judgment? Is it producing bias? Is it producing hatred? See, this is something that we have to be extremely attentive to. Because the fruit of our lives will come from the seeds that we plant in our soil. Do those seeds come from Christ? Or do those seeds come from the evil one? And this requires our attention on a day-to-day, hour-to-hour, minute-to-minute basis, because in the storm and turmoil of what constitutes our lives these days, we might not be able to tell the difference between wheat and weeds. Hear the voice of the Lord. Pay attention and tend your own garden. Because as I learned from that kind gentleman from the lawn service, sometimes it's really easy to tell the difference between wheat and weeds, but sometimes it isn't.
Thank you, Deacon James. Let us now profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth,
and in Jesus Christ,
his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Then let us pray.
For those who are suffering in the current outbreak of infectious disease, that they might be healed, and for the happy repose of all who have died from this illness in recent weeks, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For scientists, health professionals, public officials, and all who are serving the common good in this challenging and uncertain time, that they will be filled with insight, wisdom, and success in their efforts, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That in times of illness, our Heavenly Father will strengthen our faith and trust in his goodness, mercy, and providential love, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our compassionate Father in heaven will grant healing and peace to all those affected by the current outbreak with infectious disease, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And let us dedicate ourselves to defending and promoting racial and social justice, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. all things through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
And so, in company with the choir of angels and saints, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord. You are the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Leonard our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember, Lord, Seth and Blythe Kaufman, and Carmelo Indomenico, for whom we now pray. Finally, we pray, have mercy on us all, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her husband, with the apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
And we pray now with the words that Jesus gave us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, O Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
O Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, our light and our hope. Blessed are they called to the Lord's Supper.
Lord, I am not worthy to enter into my roof,
but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. For those of you who are still not able to receive communion physically, we ask Jesus to come to us in spirit. We do so by joining in this prayer for spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Jesus.
seek be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways of new, to newness of life, as we now ask through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. I thank you for joining us this morning. I thank Ava for filming, and I thank Chris for reading, Sarah and Gabriel for the music they prepared, and my brother James here for his great words. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you and those whom you love and cherish, Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen. The Mass has ended. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your lives.
Thanks be to God.